Well, I love the bite of that mote bean.
Yeah.
I think the ultimate combination is the kadi pakodi with some chawal and a generous amount of that kadi. Mix it all together and make for a nice flavorful bite. Hi folks, we're in Jaipur in Johari Bazar and we've come here to dine at a very special place. I'm with my friend Jaydeep Patil, somebody I know for many, many years. Jaydeep is passionate about his food, a great food lover and an intrepid food explorer.
Thank you, Kripal.
So Jaydeep, what are we looking at first?
I think for me, I think every city requires an iconic restaurant where people, locals can visit.
Okay.
I think this has been an icon for a very long time. We're visiting something which is called the Lakshmi Mishthan Bhandar, which is located in the heart of the city, in the old city, you can say.
So what are we expecting to be tasting here?
So they do a very extensive Rajasthani Thali up here.
Okay.
Predominantly featuring the local delicacies of the place here. Like it can be gatta ka sabzi, it will have to be the sweets like ghewar, which are going to be there, badam halwa, mung dal halwa, which is very traditional again. And it's the right time to eat all these savories as well.
Fantastic. So I'm looking forward to my lunch at Sri Lakshmi
Mishthan Bhandar.
Mishthan Bhandar here with Jaydeep. Let's go. Wow. So there's an array of sweets here. It's a combination of both a sweet shop as well as a
savory. Yes.
Alright.
You can get sweets and savories in either a dining form or where you can take it and eat it here as well, or it can be packing form as well.
Now, so this is, what is this?
This is feni. Feni is basically eaten at this point in time.
Okay.
Again made with wheat flour, which has been spun into a vermicelli, sweetened vermicelli format. Traditionally eaten with warm milk.
Okay.
It's just like...
So you basically take this and you dip it in warm milk.
Yeah, you can pour warm milk over it and then you eat it as like a granola or a cereal as well. So wow. It's a wheat cereal, obviously sweetened.
So that's the ghewar.
Yes, that's the ghewar. Ghewar is basically made with wheat flour, which has been mixed with ghee, which is basically an emulsion which is made with ghee, flour and water, ice cold water. This is a variation which is called as paneer ghewar, where you add chennai in the emulsion and then it is deep fried in a mold.
Alright.
That's why you get this finish. Once you've done this, then it goes into a sugar syrup and then a rabdi or a milk condensed is poured on the top of it, and that's how you eat it.
So what's so special about the ghewar? I mean, people here are crazy about the ghewar. That's when you come to Jaipur, yeah, you have to get the ghewar.
I think in olden times, every city looked up to a certain dessert.
Okay.
It was not that everything was available here. I think ghewar is one of the sweets that you would look up in winters,
mm-hmm,
especially during teej time, you know, when, you know, every dish would come up to its own in a particular season.
Mm.
And that's why people looked up to it. And I think everyone who visited the city in that time, they would recommend to eat ghewar. That's how the specialities and the things that are loved in a city have become popular because they were served only in that city.
It's a sort of sweet that you share.
Yes. It's not like a gulab jamun that you take individually, and something you have to cut and then eaten along with the family. Yes.
Correct. Because if you were to eat one of these ghewar just by yourself, I think you'd probably be off sweets for a very long time.
Something which is very traditional to Rajasthan again is the churma. The baseline, you see.
The badami churma.
Yeah. It is basically a crumble.
So Jaydeep, all that talk about food has made me hungry. So should we go in and something to eat?
Absolutely.
Let's go.
A special thali, na, Rajasthani Royal Thali?
Yes, sir. Rajasthan.
Okay, then two thali.
Two thali kar do.
Okay.
This is papad mangori.
Papad mangori.
Yeah.
So there's a papad in it.
Yeah.
And then these dumplings are the mangoris.
Mangori, yes. This lentil which has been crushed with some spices.
Okay.
And then it is dried, sun-dried. As you get ample of sun in this space, in this part of the world, so you can actually dry everything.
So basically this mangori is a form of preservation.
Yeah, preservation of lentils.
Okay.
Also, since there were no vegetables, people had to find some kind of protein to put in the curries. So lentils are a good source of protein. So they're just grounded and then dried.
And what is this broth?
Broth is basically made with water. There's no stock as used. But the flavor from the lentils,
that is
like a dal ka shorba kind.
Yeah,
since the lentil is ground, anything that is in ground form releases the flavor quickly.
And this is a urad papad?
Yeah, urad papad.
Lovely.
And and mangori can be made with any form of lentil.
Any form of lentil.
Moong. Moong is most preferred.
There's a certain warmth that you feel at the back of your throat. So is there any pepper in this?
Pepper, not. You can find some cloves in it.
Some cloves.
Yeah. Hing. Obviously, since you're not using garlic, a lot of places they use kind of hing to temper.
I love that soft crumbliness of that mangori.
Yeah.
That mangori has soaked in all the broth.
Yes.
So the mangori is flavoring the stock.
Yeah.
But the stock in turn has broken down that mangori. So when you taste the mangori, it kind of unburdens itself of all that flavor.
Absolutely.
That's the mangori, papad and the stock.
I think if you learn less is more, I think Rajasthan teaches you a lot of things.
So, the one thing I've realized is that delicious food is all about simplicity.
I put it the other way around for my team. I said, what is great food? It's simple food made by a great chef.
That's true. Oh, this is delicious. This is a heartwarming soup.
Yeah.
This is the perfect soup for the
winters, yeah.
For the nippy Jaipur weather.
Not too heavy because it might be sunny in the afternoon.
Ooh.
But it just sets you up because you're kind of in winters.
Oh, this is delicious. This is a light soup. It wets your palate.
Yeah.
And you want to taste more after this. This is a sort of soup that just kind of warms you gently inside and prepares you for the next dishes that are to follow. Oh, this has been a great start to our meal here at Lakshmi Mishthan Bhandar.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a big one.
So, ye masala baati hai, ye plain baati hai, ye mishri baati hai. Ye kair sangri hai. ये बेला राजस्थानी गट्टे की सब्जी है, ये दाना मेथी किशमिश है, ये आलू गोभी है, ये कड़ी है, वेस्टर्न राइस है, ये बूंदी रायता है, ये मिस्सी मावा स्वीट है, ये बाजरे की चूरमा है, ये गेहूँ की चूरमा है, ये दाल फ्राई है, दोनों बाटी को क्रश करना ऐसे करना है, ये प्लेन बाटी है, ये मसाले बाटी है और ये दोनों चूरमा को मिक्स करना है.
ये कौन सा चूरमा है?
ये
बाजरे की चूरमा.
और ये मिस्सी रोटी है सर, आप एक केक सांगरी और गट्टे के साथ कॉम्बिनेशन है, कड़ी राइस के साथ कॉम्बिनेशन है, बाकी आप अपने टेस्ट के
अनुसार. ऑल राइट, थैंक यू.
So that was a helpful demonstration of the Dal Bati Churma by Pawan Prasad. So I'm going to go for that Dal Bati. I think this is a plain one, right?
That's a tough one.
And this is a plain one. So the Bati is made with
wheat flour.
Wheat flour.
Wheat flour, salt and some water mixed in, or sometimes whey of yogurt.
And just dumpling.
Yeah,
just
and baked in ash.
Baked in ash.
Ash are buried under the sand and then the bonfires were created. So that by the end you could have a Bati which was baked.
Wow.
So that's how they could sustain.
That's a fascinating story.
Yeah.
So the warrior food.
Yeah.
Here goes. There's a certain graininess in that bite.
Mm.
The graininess comes from?
They have little suji in the bati.
Mm.
Just to give the texture.
And there's also some sugar. There's a hint of sugar that
You're getting it from the churma.
Ah, okay. So the server Pawan Prasad decided to mix the dal bati churma for us. So I'm getting some sweetness that comes from the churma. Oh, but that's quite a comforting bite. Mm.
Mm. Maybe in a space which is air conditioned. Imagine if you're sitting out in cold weather. It's such a comforting food.
So next I'm going to go for the masala bati. So the masala bati is stuffed. I can see it's a little red.
Stuffed with lentils and spices. It can be potatoes also sometimes. Yeah, just a plain bati.
So this is just the atta, little semolina.
Yeah, mixed together with a little water. That's the bharwa bati. Generally, it can have various fillings inside. This one has lentils and some spices. It can have potato, it can have peas.
You know, I find that dal bati churma to be such a comforting bite.
Yeah.
Actually, just the bati and the dal by itself too.
That's like dal chawal.
It's dal chawal. Yeah. It's so nourishing. You've got that creamy goodness of the lentils and then you've got that crunch of that bati. And I think that semolina adds character to that bati. Otherwise, it would just be bereft of some texture, I think. Yeah.
No, also, in olden times, the flour mills were not so refined. You know, the flour generally grinded on stone grinders at home. So naturally, the wheat was not so fine. And when people realized that they were not getting the right texture, they started adding semolina. That's a variation that we adopted.
Okay. So earlier they would get the right texture.
Earlier, because the grinding mills were
coarser,
the meals were very coarser.
So you would get the crunch of the atta.
Yeah, atta. Entire wheat been grinded.
So now because you're missing that crunch of the atta.
Yeah, that's the adaptation that people have done now.
Jaydeep here certainly knows his food. So the churma that I'm going to be tasting next, I want to taste it just by itself. So this is the two churmas. So one.
So there was bajra.
This is a bajra churma.
Bajra again is millet. Millets are eaten across Rajasthan in a lot of other formats. You can make a kheech, bajre ki kheech, which is like a porridge. And then this one is churma. Churma can be made either this way or this is just bread roti, which is bajre ki roti, which has been crushed. Also, it is called malida in certain places.
So the sweetness in this churma, where does that come from?
So it's basically bajre ki bati, which is made like this, something like that. And then once it is roasted or fried, and now it is fried because olden time it was roasted, then it is crumbled and then you add sugar or jaggery to it.
I think this has jaggery to it.
Yeah.
This is the
Aate ka churma.
So this is only wheat.
Yeah, wheat.
Similar concept. Yeah, yeah. Similar. So again, it's made into a bati first and then crumbled and then mixed with...
It's made into like a dumpling.
Into a dumpling.
Not exactly a bati, a dumpling.
Okay.
Which is fried. It was baked also initially. But this is fried and then it is made into a coarse powder and then you add seasoning, sugar and a little bit of cardamom. Some nuts sometimes. Ghee obviously is added.
That's a tasty churma.
Yeah.
So this combination of, let's say, the dal with the bati and some of that churma. So it's basically...
Like a complete meal.
It's a complete meal and it's a whole medley of flavors,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Have some papad.
Yeah, papad.
Go show it tastes next.
You can taste the gatta. Kair sangri is obviously
must. Kair sangri.
Desert beans and berries, which are rehydrated with yogurt, rehydrated, and then they're just simply tempered with some.
So kair is basically these strands.
Kair is a berry. That's a sangri that you picked up. That's
so
a kair.
This is a kair.
Yeah,
that's which a kair. Is a desert berry.
That's a berry, a desert berry.
A lot of ghee in this. So that's basically just to kind of make sure that your body stays warm.
Yeah. Because everything in there is very dry, you know. It has to have some kind of...
So there's some ghee, there's also some chili in this.
Yeah.
This is a spicy...
Yeah, it's a very traditional rice.
You can definitely taste the spice in this. So what do you typically eat this with?
It's eaten with either plain roti.
With this?
Yeah, you can eat it with Missi roti also. You can eat something. There's something called Bejad ki roti also, which is very popular in Rajasthan.
This is certainly a spicy dish, the kair sangri. So this is again winter food.
Yeah, it's very winter food.
I think the roti, the Missi ki roti manages to tone down the spices to a certain extent. Look at this is smeared with a generous amount of ghee. So next, what should we be tasting?
This gatta.
The gatte ki sabzi.
Yeah. Kadi or sabzi.
Gatte ki kadi.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a gatta.
Yeah.
This is again made with...
gram flour.
Gram flour.
Gram flour, some buttermilk, spices crushed in.
Okay.
Then it is rolled into a dough, rolled into a tube.
Okay.
Not a tube, a cylinder, and then it is poached in water.
Okay.
And then it is either fried.
So this is basically a yogurt
Yogurt kadi.
Yeah, yogurt kadi.
Kadi or curry, you can call, whatever you can call.
Mm. You know that savory flavor of that ghatta juxtaposes, contrasts so beautifully.
Absolutely.
With that smooth, mellow, you know, flavors of that curry.
Yes.
Well, this is delicious. I'm going to taste some of that with the rice. I think it'll make for a great accompaniment to my rice. So I've got some rice, I've got some ghatte ki kadi.
Yeah, ghatte ki sabzi.
Such a satisfying bite. You know, the KAIR SANGRI, almost in a manner of speaking, because it's so strong in its flavors and spice, it's kind of like a vegetable but also like a pickle of sorts. You can't really eat too much of that.
You get KAIR pickle as well.
Mm.
Yeah. It's very close to pickling.
But that combination of that ghatte ki kadi, rice and that KAIR SANGRI, oh, it's delicious.
Yeah. And if you actually eat it with everything in a plate, no, it actually blends in well together in terms of flavor, in terms of the lightness of the dal. The bharwa bati has a strong built-in flavor.
You know, that's the thing about, I think, the food in this country, right? You go to any region, you've got so much variety.
Yeah.
And the way they all come together.
Yeah.
So you can taste one dish, you can taste each dish just by itself, but you can also then start bringing things together.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
What is this?
So this is Kishmish. This is a raisin and a dal together, lentil together.
So the lentil is a personality in almost every dish.
Everything.
It's that's the protein source.
Yeah.
What is this called?
So this is basically dal mot, which is basically
the mot bean.
Mot bean, yes. Which has been
with some raisins.
Raisins, yes.
With some raisins, with some chilies.
Yeah. This is like a sweet and sour. Now again, this is kind of influence.
Well,
of
I love the bite of that mot bean.
Yeah.
So it's kind of very yielding.
Yeah.
You know, it's got a very pleasant, soft
texture,
crunch to it.
Yeah.
In a manner of speaking, it's almost like barley when you bite into
yes,
it.
Yes, correct. That's correct.
Right? I love the flavors of this dal mot kishmish ki sabzi.
Yeah.
The fenugreek.
Yeah.
Mmm. I love that texture of that mot
fenugreek. Yeah.
I think the fenugreek also kind of brings in
a little bitterness.
A little bitterness.
So that you want to eat raisins.
Mmm.
And when you eat raisin, you want to eat the spice. And in the triangle, you kind of finish mop of this dish. This is aloo gobi.
This is a simple aloo gobi ki sabzi. Yeah. And I think this I should mop up with some of that Missi roti. I think that's the one dish that didn't make too much of an impression with me.
Yeah, because it is, that's not something that is kind of come in later, you know, not very traditional in terms of
I think let's move on to the kadi pakoda. Again, this is made with basil.
Yeah, it's basic.
So yogurt, there's some jeera in this.
Yeah, jeera, fenugreek, fennel, some hing, fresh chilies, ghee.
The yogurt is a little sweet, but I think it's more sour than sweet.
Yeah.
I think the ultimate combination is the kadi pakodi with some chawal and a generous amount of that kadi. Mix it all together and make for a nice flavorful bite. Mm. So this thali is more a representation of the flavors,
yes,
the general flavors of the land. I'm
yes,
sure when you go into certain villages, certain areas,
yes,
you probably have a whole lot of nuances in the food.
Absolutely.
This is just a raita.
Yeah.
So if you need some cooling respite at the end of the Royal Rajasthani Thali, there's some raita here, the Boondi raita.
Yeah.
Mmm. This is nice and sweet.
Yes, sweet as well. Some spices have been added.
Ah, this is chatpata.
Yeah.
Oh, I love this. I love this. So I think if you have one of these thalis here, Jaydeep, it can be the only meal for the day.
Yeah.
Also, mind you, this Royal Rajasthani Thali is unlimited. So which means they bring you this huge heavy salver and you can ask them to refill whatever you want as much as you want. So you can literally eat to your heart's content. So when you come here for lunch, don't eat breakfast. And if you come here for lunch, don't make plans for dinner.
Absolutely.
Almost missed the dessert here, the sweet here.
The Mishri Mawa.
The Mishri Mawa.
Yeah.
We basically reduced milk.
Yeah.
So this is the
dessert if you were to not include the dal bati churma.
Rich, very simple, reduced milk with sugar.
It's basically made with milk which has been reduced, like a kalakand or you can call it a milk condensate in any forms. Kalakand or a milk cake, the same philosophy. It's mawa that has been sweetened.
Dairy, sugar.
Yeah.
What's there not to like?
And right amount of sugar sometimes helps.
And the right amount of sugar. So Jaydeep, I've really enjoyed tasting this Royal Rajasthani Thali with you, and I think, you know, it's fantastic that you were able to walk me through the nuances of each dish. I think what's special for me here is that each dish, although it draws, I mean, many of the dishes draw from lentils.
Yes.
Right? Whether it's the basin, whether it's the other lentils. But each one of the preparation is so unique.
Unique in terms of flavor profile, yes.
That's right. So you don't really feel like you're tasting the same flavors.
Absolutely.
As you go from katori to katori to katori.
Yes.
So if you find yourself in Jaipur and want to taste the flavors of the land, do visit LMB.
Yes.
That's what the locals call it.
Yes.
Lakshmi Mishthan Bhandar, and check out the Royal Rajasthani Thali. It's about 600 rupees and rich in the flavors and cuisine of the land. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and
happy eating.
Happy eating.